Swayam Prabha, Digital India, Educated India.
it is required that one plus 3 k 1 plus k 3, this must be greater than 0, 4 omega 0 square k 1 times k 3, this should also be greater than 0. In addition, 1 plus 3 k 1 plus k 1 k 3 square minus 4 times 4, this term omega 0 square k 1 k 3, this should also be greater than 0. This you know very well, that the coefficients of this polynomial in S, this must be positive. Okay, this quantity is positive. So, this must be positive if we do not want to have any roots in the right half complex plane. Okay, so, if so happens that the roots are in the right half complex plane, means the system becomes unstable. From the Descartes rule, you know it, know that in any polynomial, if we are writing it like this, say the polynomial is f x and you are writing here as x to the power n times a 1 times x to the power n minus 1 and so on. Okay, so, the nth order polynomial. So, as many sign changes, so number of roots in the right half complex plane, it is bounded by the number of sign changes that takes place in the coefficient of this polynomial. This is the Descartes rule. But what we are looking for, that there should not be any root in the right half complex plane for the stability to be maintained. So, therefore, I do not want any sign change, means all these coefficients, this and this, they must be positive. Similarly, if we are looking for the roots in the left half complex plane, okay, so what we will do, we will change this to the f minus x. Okay, and so the x here will be replaced by this minus x, and then we will look for how many sign changes are there. This is also part of the Descartes rule. So, that will tell you the what is the upper bound on the number of roots in the left half complex plane or the on the negative side. So, here it so happens that if you put here s equal to minus s, so only in these two places there is nothing changes here in this equation. So, this simply implies that if these are positive, so there is no roots in the left half complex plane. So, it is a purely imaginary roots exist in this case, and moreover this condition must be satisfied. You can check yourself by taking some simple example of this quartic form, okay, and then trying to find out the rules. So, if this quantity is not greater than 0, so your condition will not be satisfied for the stability, means we know here in this case that all the roots are purely imaginary, all the roots are purely imaginary. Okay, we can not take what I mean, that if here what we have written, that s to the power 4, if I write the equation like this, b s square plus c. So, you can write s square equal to minus b plus minus b square minus 4 a c, and this is under root divided by 2. So, this is the part we are talking about. So, if this condition must be satisfied, if we do not want any roots in the right half complex plane, and you can check using a very simple example for this. Okay. So, this 4 into 4, this is nothing but 16 here. So, in this place, so on the next page maybe we can write. So, the in summary, for stability, this k 1 times k 3, this must be greater than 0, then 1 plus 3 k 1 plus k 1 times k 3, this must be greater than 0, and moreover this condition should also be satisfied, 1 plus 3 k 1 plus k 1 times k 3, this whole square must be greater than 16 omega 0 square. Here we are missing this omega 0 part. So, omega 0 square. So, this is omega 0 we have picked up this part from here to here, omega 0 square is there. So, omega 0 we need to put here in this place, and somewhere we have missed some particular this square part. Here we have, here this is the 4 omega 0 to the power 4 k 1 k 3. So, this 4 we have missed, instead we have written here as 2. So, this is your 4. Okay. So, here this should be 4, and here also this should appear as 4. So, omega 0, this quantity is always a positive quantity. So, the we can summarize like this, k 1 times k 3 should be greater than 0, 1 plus 3 k 1 times k 3, this should be greater than 0. And here if you look for this part, so this is omega, this also becomes omega to the power 4, and here there is omega to the power 4. So, this can get eliminated because it is a positive sign, so positive quantity. So, thus we get that this quantity square should be greater than 16 k 1 k 3, this is 16 k 1 k 3. So, these are the conditions for to be satisfied for the stability. So, these are the condition, now we have to analyze it. Okay. We have got the condition that under this condition we get the purely imaginary roots, and based on this how these conditions will help you in designing the spacecraft. And what is about the design? We want to choose the values of capital I 1, this is the, we want to choose the inertia matrix basically, I 1, I 2, I 3, these are the things we want to choose. So, will it guide me in doing so? So, we will take up this problem in the next lecture, and for the time being, thank you very much for listening.